Well, the return on equity ratio is another type of profitability ratio. And as a profitability ratio, we know that we're trying to measure how effective a company is at generating some type of profit. That is the ultimate goal with profitability ratios like the return on equity or like earnings per share. But return on equity does things a little bit differently. So here, we're measuring a corporate's or a corporation's profitability for that matter, but we're actually showing how a company generates that profit compared to the money that's invested. And this is a really important metric because companies can generate very similar amounts of profitability, but they can use different amounts of investment, which of course would mean that one company had more resources to generate that same level of profitability. Now, the return on equity ratio, commonly just shown as ROE, is calculated by taking net income, which you can find on an income statement, and dividing that figure by the total owner's equity or stockholders' equity. Again, like most financial ratios, it's a very simple calculation, but the number that we get helps us draw a number of different conclusions. And so let's say that we had a net income of $49,000 and we had owner's equity of $213,000. Well, dividing those two numbers together, that would actually get us 0.23, which we could show as a percentage or 23%. Now, if you remember from our video or my video on return on sales, this percentage is pretty meaningful because it essentially represents that for every dollar in equity, the firm was able to generate 23 cents in profit. So as an investor, when you're looking at companies to potentially put your money into and then, of course, get some kind of common stock, you're looking at return on equity to see, well, how much profit does every dollar that you invest in that company, how much does it actually generate? Now, the typical rule of thumb for investments, and again, like most things, you want to take a look at historically what has been return on equity for the firm, but you also want to compare it to other companies in the similar industry. But historically, an ROE, you want it to be at least above 15%. So what that means is that for every dollar that you're investing in the company, the firm is generating at least 15 cents in profitability. The higher, the better, of course. That just means the firm is that much more successful at taking those investments and generating profit. If you have a lower return on equity, that usually could indicate that the firm is not utilizing the equity effectively. And you can get into, you know, kind of the why behind that. Is it because of the types of products that they sell? Is it the market that they sell in? Are there some issues there? Are consumer preferences changing? Is technology making it so that the original product line is no longer necessary? What is the reason why the ROE is not higher than it currently is? But ultimately, return on equity is a very helpful measure to be able to determine if a company is being successful at utilizing its investments to generate profitability.